Routine screening for HPV in asymptomatic men is currently not recommended. Boring? On the contrary, this sentence has profound implications for many a relationship, because nowadays, at least here in Germany, HPV awareness has risen to a point where women send their new partners to the doctor for testing on sexually transmitted infections, STI, before they engage in sexual intercourse for the first time. On the other hand, screening for HPV-related cervical cancer is routine in women, which means that as soon as that screening is positive, the question arises, who gave it to me? With the result that the current partner is sent to the doctor for testing. And when the doctor, that's me, answers that he is not going to test the man for HPV, a lot of explaining has to be done. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. If you like my content, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks a lot. So here's what you need to know about HPV. HPV is the so-called human papillomavirus. It is a large family of different types of viruses, of which types 16 and 18 are known as the dangerous ones, as they may cause cancer in the infected sites. That's the cervix, the penis, the anus, and the oral cavity. Other family members cause warts. Others don't do anything. The HPV virus is extremely common. Just 2 years after their sexual debut, 80% of the people have had contact with it. Most will never find out that they were infected, and if symptoms appear, it takes several months. So if you have sex with multiple partners, it is very unlikely for you to find out who gave it to you. Luckily, the body is able to get rid of most HPV infections within 2 years. When a man is sent by his partner for testing, all I do is look for warts in the genital area, the mouth, and the anus. I also look underneath the foreskin for lesions suspicious of penile cancer. However, penile cancer is not a common disease in my part of the world, so as a urologist, one doesn't get to see many during his career. If the examination doesn't reveal anything, that's it. That's the screening test. If I find lesions, then they will have to be treated. But I don't perform swab tests to look for genetic material of the virus. First of all, because the interpretation of these tests is difficult and unreliable in men. And secondly, and that's a very important reason, there is nothing I can do to clear the infection. In other words, we don't have a treatment. So what would happen if I did an unreliable DNA test, finding HPV and telling the patient, you've contracted HPV, but I can't do anything for you? I think this would disturb many patients and partnerships. But I mean, for what? As I said in the beginning, HPV is extremely common. And even if both partners are positive with the same subgroup of HPV, it is not for certain where it came from in terms of latency and persistence. Maybe the man is positive not because he infected his wife, but because she infected him with something she had acquired a long time ago. Positive test results automatically raise suspicion of cheating, which may be an issue, don't get me wrong, but many times there was no cheating involved. So a meaningless test could have major interpersonal consequences for the couple. And it's not worth it, because we can't do anything about it anyway. If you want to stay HPV-free, there is only one way. Never engage in sex. Ever. That includes oral sex and anal sex, by the way. If you ask me what you should do, get vaccinated. The vaccine covers 9 different subtypes of HPV and is very effective. However, there's a catch with vaccines. They are most effective when used before the body has had any contact with the virus, and that is ideally before the first sex. It is possible to get vaccinated later in life, and there is still some protection, but ideally, one would do this during the preteen years, starting age 9 for both girls and boys. This will offer you the most protection against HPV. Officially, vaccination after the age of 26 is not recommended, but under special circumstances, it might also be possible later. Condoms is always a good idea when it comes to STIs, but for HPV, they are inferior to the vaccine. So share this video with your family and friends to let them know that there is an effective way of fighting HPV, but it has to be done early. And even if it's not about cancer, nobody wants genital warts. Believe me, nobody. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.